Welcome back to Decrescendo, episode 3. My name is Nate. Decrescendo is my own personal podcast, solo podcast, where I just talk about everything that's on my mind, kind of as a mental health outlet, as sorts. With the new year here, first off, happy new year to everybody. Hope you had a fantastic Christmas with your family, loved ones, whatever you had going on, as well as a great and safe New Year's. I sat home with my pups, which is perfectly fine with me. I very much enjoy their company, and I'm pretty sure they enjoy mine. So, with the new year being here, like I was saying, I think that this is going to be something that I'm going to be doing a little bit more formally. In that respect, it's going to be more scheduled, at least once a week, if not, actually we'll go at least every other week, if not weekly. But we'll play that by ear. Just depends on what I got going on that week and where my head's at and stuff like that. So it's been a little bit since we talked. I think the last time that we talked, I had mentioned that I had been taken out of work for at least 3 months. If you didn't know, I work as a fireman in a town close to me, and mental health has been something that I've been struggling with for quite a few years, and it finally just came to a head, and because of that, I was taken out of work to get a psychiatric eval, and it sounds bad, but it wasn't that bad. It was just more so just making sure that I am still capable to perform the functions of the job that I have to do for my patients and everybody that I'm called to serve. Completely understand, you know, it was no ill will. I completely understand why I was taken out of work, stuff like that. That was the beginning of November. And then I saw a psychiatrist that my employer found for me that was separate from my own. I have been seeing another psychiatrist for medication and stuff like that since about July, so. But they wanted someone impartial and everything like that. Again, completely understand. So my employer found one, went and saw him. The first meeting that we had was just sitting for a couple hours like you do in any therapy session or whatever, and you just talk, kind of cover everything from the very second you were born until the day that you're sitting in this guy's office or whatever. After we'd finished that, he said that he wanted a personality test done, or a couple tests done. So the following week, I came back and he administered personality testing. And that was, both of these happened on a Monday, for one right after another. Had to sit down, kind of one-on-one chat one Monday, and then the following Monday was the testing. And then later on in that same week is when he came back and said that he didn't feel comfortable sending me back to work just yet. He said that he noted some signs of PTSD and severe depression between the conversation and the testing that we did. I didn't get an in-depth report from it. That was more so just, you know, all that stuff went to my doctors and everything like that. So, but yeah, he said minimum 3 months. I had mentioned that I was looking into getting some talk therapy started. I was just looking for a counselor at that point. I finally settled on one, shortly after, his verdict came out that he didn't feel comfortable sending me back. And again, I completely respect the decision. I have no ill will towards anything. I'm not upset about any of this. It was it was gonna come to a head at one point or another, and luckily I think it was the best time for everything to kind of happen, if that makes sense. So yeah, anyway, I found I had asked my psychiatrist for some recommendations of counselors, people that, you know, specialize in talk therapy and stuff like that, and she gave me some. but I went on and I found some that were just, it's literally 5 minutes from where I live, so that makes everything super easy. Nice staff, everything's great there. So far I've only been there twice. But I did start my, I had the preliminary kind of meeting with the counselor. And the first one wasn't with, my specific counselor. It was more so just a preliminary thing. Come in, to see what's going on, what are my issues, what do I want to achieve, through therapy, so on and so forth. And then from there, they kind of pinpointed a therapist that would be best for my situation. And just, you know, that was at the beginning of December. And then, you know, their schedule and everything like that, and then holidays and everything like that, I wasn't able to start my first session until just after Christmas. So I think it was almost a week ago was when I had my first session. And I actually really enjoyed it. We didn't obviously dive too deep in anything. It was the way she explained it was that the first few weeks are, first few sessions I should say, are going to be just kind of getting to know each other, just kind of creating that safety zone, I guess we'll call it, so that I feel more willing to talk about everything that's, you know, bothering me and everything like that. And I'm pretty outspoken about all this stuff. I think that mental health as a whole, for everybody, shouldn't be this taboo subject that it is. I feel like everybody, and that's something that we'll touch on later on in the episode. But yeah, that's the first session was, like I said, just kind of getting to know each other, kind of, you know, explaining myself, explaining what my situation was, explaining where my problem areas were. Excuse me. Explaining what I was hoping to get out of this, and then coming up with a treatment plan. I'm already scheduled for another couple sessions. I think I go next week again. I think I got two more scheduled for this month, and then so on and so forth. But yeah, it'll be good. I'm excited for it. Actually, I am really excited for it. I feel like over the past few years, aside from my job, my mental health has just been a hindrance in anything else that I've wanted to achieve. And I've noticed it even now. It's still, you know, the way I describe it is before I got into medications and stuff like that I'm on, I could think myself into a bad mood. And I'm sure there's people out there that understand 100% what that means. But I could just, exactly that, just think myself into a bad mood. And since July, I've been on anti-depression medication, anti-anxiety medication for a couple years now through my primary doctor. But just this July, I started seeing a psychiatrist who took over the medication and stuff like that, and adjusted it accordingly and everything. Obviously, with psychiatric medications, the big fear out there is that it's going to suppress the person that you actually are. Kind of turn you into a zombie is what I've heard. And that's what I was afraid of, obviously. That's all you really hear is that, you know, psychiatric medications just turn you into a person that you're not. Turn you into a shell of the human being that you used to be. And I didn't want to do that because I still enjoy a lot of things, you know, hanging out with my dogs, playing guitar, playing video games, streaming, all that stuff. And I didn't want medication to take that away from me. But my psychiatrist said that, and actually the other day my therapist kind of added on to it, that the medication that I'm on Celexa is kind of a more mild psychiatric medication, so it doesn't really tend to have those side effects. When you get into the more serious stuff, I guess it's when you start seeing stuff like that, but there's ways around that. So but yeah, so I since July, once I started on that stuff, and then a few months later when I started ADHD medication, I've been in quite a chipper mood. And I was, you know, still at work as I started these medications and adjusted dosages and stuff like that. So I did feel like I was in much better mood, but I was still you know, anxious about going to work and just different aspects about my job and all that stuff, which prompted me to make the first video that I did, which subsequently ended up becoming why I got taken out of work. Again, I'm not upset with any of that. I want to stress that I'm not upset with any of that. I completely understand all that. But yeah, so started set therapy. It's not going to be an overnight fix. I don't want it to be an overnight fix. I want it to be a long-term thing. But like I was saying, is I started streaming again, and I started trying to create as much content as I can because I do have a passion for content creation. The inverse of what my job is, content creation is a more positive thing for me because it's something that I really enjoy, and it makes me happy because I'm putting content out there that potentially could in turn cheer somebody else up, whether it's the stream, the video game that I'm playing, whatever, music, all that stuff. But yeah, so that's where I'm at with that. And I was good. I was trying to stream for 100 days in a row. But I'm realizing that, and I was good at it. I was up until just before Christmas. I took a weekend off simply because there's a charity event that I didn't want to, not that my, you know, one viewer streams would take away too much from the event, but I wanted to, you know, be in the chat for that and be a part of the community for that. So I sat through, I decided not to stream, and I just participated as much as I could in the charity event. And then started back up the following after all that was over with. And then I started missing a few days. And I realized that even though I'm only streaming a few hours, I'm not doing the insane hours or streaming 8 hours a day or whatever like that. I'm only streaming for 3-4 hours a night. I was starting to kind of get burnt out from it. And that's not so much that I was, you know, the streaming side of the gaming side of it. It's tough, you know, only streaming to yourself. And I try to do the best that I can. I try to create a positive environment and, you know, chat or talk as much as I can, you know, all the helpful tips and stuff that I see other creators give to us smaller creators. And I tried doing that, but I can only do it for so long before it's like, okay, well, I'm running out of things to talk about type thing, so. But I think I'm going to adjust that and only start streaming. I don't know if I want to do 3 days a week or if I want to do 2 days a week and then the other days just work on other long form content, so on and so forth. That remains to be seen. I just gotta test some different things and see what works best for me and move on with that. I'm not 100% sure if or when I'll be going back to work. 3 months is coming up here pretty quick. I don't want to get too deep into that because there's some things going through my head and there's some conversations that I have to have with some people to decide what's the best option. So, but something that's been on my mind for quite some time now is that I feel that I'm meant to be helping people. Not that my job isn't helping people. It is helping people. And it's a very positive way that I'm helping, you know, that person that I'm, or those people, that community that I'm called to, you know, serve. But it's not helping me in a positive way. And you can say that that's selfish, what have you, but I don't know if I can continue doing something that is not a positive influence for me. I want to start doing things that are more, that are positive for me, but also positive for other people. I've said positive 30,000 times in the last 30 seconds, but there's, I think that I am meant to create something bigger than what I am now and what I will ever be. Something that is going to far outlast me, something that I can pass on to generations. I'm still doing the real estate stuff, obviously, with the holidays and stuff like that. You know, everything's slowed down. Now that it's the new year, it'll start picking up again. I'll start getting more into that. I'm actually starting a class on Friday to kind of help market myself better and so on and so forth. So really excited for that, actually. That's every Friday morning for the next 14 weeks. So really looking forward to that. And I think that it's going to be super beneficial. But I think that that is also a stepping stone into creating something that is bigger than me and something that will outlast me and hopefully generations of my family. I have an idea for what I want to do. And it's centered around mental health. Like I said earlier, that I want to really get rid of this taboo idea that it's, that you can't talk about what you're feeling. Because that's not the case. You absolutely should be able to talk about what you're feeling. And it should be normal to be able to talk about what you're feeling, and it's not. Obviously, it's time and place. Like, not everybody is equipped to help whoever that person is get through whatever is bothering them, if that makes sense. Maybe it's just a temporary thing that, you know, a work issue, financial issue, stuff like that. Something that can be maybe not fixed relatively quickly, but with some positive reinforcement from a friend or family member, you know, it can be better. But there are times where, like, professionals need to step in. And there's nothing wrong with that at all. There is absolutely nothing wrong with seeking professional help for your mental well-being. Because at some point with certain things in life, your friends and family can only do so much, and it's you have to have somebody that's impartial to step in and give you the proper tools to be able to deal with whatever you're dealing with. I have no interest in pursuing any sort of like education in like psychology or social whatever, you know, that stuff is. I just want to be an advocate for the mental health community and turn it into something that it's readily talked about on a daily basis. I think that's a huge issue that we're lacking in this country and probably worldwide. Mental health is just, it's almost suppressed to a point of non-existence, or we're trying to just make it seem like it's a non-existent thing when it is absolutely a raging volcano that is at some point going to erupt, and it's not going to be pretty when it does. But yeah, I have ideas and things that I want to do. I'm trying to figure out the proper steps to do them. In the meantime, what I'm trying to do is just create spaces that I can control, be it my streams, content, music, those things I can create, and create some sort of safe environment for people to come and just hang out and know that they're welcome and that they're loved. Because that's, at the end of the day, I feel like that's all that matters, is just wanting to feel like you are wanted, which is something that I deal with on a daily basis, essentially. So aside from that, I think that's kind of the biggest thing that I wanted to hit on really for this episode. Other things going on, you know, in the sports world. I'm a big Buffalo Bills fan. Got a big game coming up on Sunday, 8:00. Definitely not going to be streaming for that. We'll see how my sister's family feeling. Maybe I'll go hang out with them, but we'll see. Or I might just sit at home and watch it. Who knows? But The Bills go to Miami, play the Dolphins. And it's kind of a weird situation where they either get second, get the second seed and the AFC East division, or they could potentially just be out of the playoffs in general. So, absolutely massive game. The Dolphins, on the other hand, they're a little bit safer. They're kind of in the playoffs regardless. The Bills, on the other hand, it is kind of a if we end up losing this game, then we're going to need some help from some other teams. I can't remember what situations, what the scenarios are, but yeah, that should be a good game. Excuse me. I'm sure you've seen me kind of play with this a little bit. I did get back into picking up the guitar a little bit more, trying to practice it and start working on it progressively. I'm going back to almost a beginner level and breaking it down, learning scales, all that stuff. And this thing right here just kind of helps strengthen my fingers a little bit, helps with this dexterity and all that stuff. And I just leave it. I'm at my desk most of the time anyway. My parents gave me this chair. I don't know if it's a chair, if it's a couch, whatever it is. It's got two chairs. It kind of reclines and everything like that. But I don't know what it is about that thing, but the second that I sit in it, I end up falling asleep. I literally just woke up from my nap a little bit ago because I sat down. I went down to hang out with my dogs before I came up and did this. And ended up falling asleep in it. So that thing has some sort of magical powers. And I fall asleep. So I do sit in it and hang out with the dogs a little bit here and there, but for the most part, I truly try not to. Once my dogs wake me up in the morning, I've really been trying to stay up throughout the day and not be so lazy and just going back to bed, trying to work on different projects that I really want to get going, trying to explore different routes of how I can get to where I want to go, and so on and so forth. Plus, just, you know, waiting for that first call for somebody that wants to buy or sell their house. So I know that's coming any day. It has to be. But I could be doing more about marketing myself as well. And that's something that I definitely need to start working on as well. Something else I was going to talk about. Oh, yeah, with music, I started getting into FL Studio more the last few days. I think Bailey just yawned. It sounded like someone was screaming. I don't know if the mic probably won't pick that up or not, but yeah, I started to open up FL Studio more and just kind of playing around with different things, trying to come up with different ideas and just getting back into it, trying to get back into the mindset of a music producer and all that. There is an artist in Buffalo that was looking for guitarists. I reached out and expressed my interest in becoming their guitarist. I haven't heard anything on that. They do need a guitarist for a gig coming up. So hopefully I hear back soon, but I'm almost thinking that I'm not going to, which is fine. Totally fine. So, but, and then, the other thing is just kind of, I'm just trying to come up with different ideas that are more, personal, you know, more long form type stuff that aren't the video game content that I'm making and stuff like that. And I've been in my house for a year now. I bought my house. I moved in a year ago, December 30th. So that's quite exciting. And there's a whole bunch of different projects that I want to do and I've started and I need to finish. Money is an issue with that, but that's neither here nor there. But this year, 2024 is going to be a good year. I can feel it. It's either going to be an extremely successful year in one way or another, or we're going to start back from square one and start all over again. The thing about success is you have to be willing to fail. countless times before that one thing actually gets you to the success that you want. So, but I think that covers everything that I really wanted to talk about in this episode. I think I'm gonna do a little bit better idea. I'm gonna try to, as I think of stuff throughout the week, I'll write it down so I have a more formalized. The podcast itself isn't gonna be a more formal thing. I talk about formal; it's just gonna be on my side. Just trying to, you know, have things ready to go, prepared so I can talk. And it's just not kind of off the cuff situation, which I do kind of want it to be off the cuff, but at the same time I feel like I should have some sort of schedule's not the word that I want, but something to kind of go off of. If you listen to if you sat here and listened to the whole entire 30 minutes of this, I do appreciate it. If you're new here, do me a favor, hit that subscribe button, hit the like button.